This person came to a sheikh, and there was a person there, and he asked a question. He said, "You know what? My wudu, how does the wudu break? You know, ablution wudu? You know, wudu?" So somebody asked, he said, "Look, if I pass air and wind gas, does your wudu break?" He says, "Yeah, it's definitely, even if you don't hear or sound or anything, yeah, it breaks." There was a brother there sitting there, near next to the sheikh, who thought he was qualified, but he wasn't qualified. Yeah? You know, some people who think they're qualified, they think they're mujtahid, but he wasn't. He said, "Sheikh, what are you saying?" He said, "Repeat it." He said, if you pass gas and air and wind, even if you don't hear a sound, your wudu breaks." He said, "I don't think so." He said, "What?" He said, "Hadith. I read the hadith myself. There's a hadith in the Sunan, and this is a hadith." Yeah? Clear. You can pick up Sunan Abi Dawud. I can show you my iPhone right now. I've got the whole 6 books on this. There's a hadith in the Sunnah of Imam Abu Dawud rahimahullah ta'ala. La wudu'a illa min sawtin aw rihin. Your wudu does not break if you don't hear a sound or if you don't smell. If you pass gas, but you couldn't hear or you try to smell. You couldn't smell. The hadith, literally, that's what the hadith is saying. You know what the hadith is saying? If you pass gas and wind, or we say, you know, you fart, basically, that's the English term. La wudu'a illa min sawtin aw rihin. Sound, or, because either or, normally it's either the sound or the smell, you know? It's either one. If there's a loud sound, normally you don't have the smell. But if it's silent, they say in English, silent, they're deadly. But anyway, this is what the hadith said. He said it's a sound hadith. And I checked it, the imam said it was hadithun hasan. And it was. It is a sound hadith. It is a sound hadith. The sheikh said, "Yeah, yeah, definitely, this hadith is sound." He said, "Then what did you say to him?" He said, "Are you still saying it doesn't break? Your wudu breaks?" He said, "Yes." So what about this hadith? What are you going to do?" He said, "The sheikh explained to me, brother, look, you need to understand. There's a context behind this hadith. Look at the other versions of this hadith. Go into the background of this hadith. Check all the detailed commentary on all the different variations." And then he showed him another report from another book of the same hadith of the incident that took place. A man who had the disease of obsessive compulsive disorder, OCD. Yeah? Who came to the messenger and kept to the messenger of Allah. "I think I broke my wudu. I think I passed away. I think I passed gas. He said it so many times, the Messenger of Allah said to him, "You know, for you, like people who are like OCD, you need to tell them emphatically. For you, if you don't hear anything, if you don't smell anything, your wudu is not broken. But that's for you." You know, like some people, this one guy, you know, came to me, he thinks every day he's dreaming about divorce. He thinks he divorced his wife like 20 times a day. OCD. I tell him, for you, the rules of divorce don't apply. Just go home. Okay, that doesn't mean that it doesn't apply. It does apply. But he told him so emphatically. Which means that you have to have yaqeen. Your wudu will not break unless you have yaqeen. You're 100% sure. But if you are sure that you passed, you're 100% sure you passed gas and air and wind, but you didn't smell or you didn't hear, your wudu is still broken. It's still broken. Everybody, there's no Muslim who doesn't say that. It's still broken. Do you understand my point? It's still broken. Otherwise, someone whose nose is blocked and our ears are blocked, his wudu will never break. If you have a flu and you've got blocked ears as well, your wudu is not going to break for 2 days. Otherwise, that won't happen. The meaning of the hadith is that you have to be sure. If you're sure, even though you can't smell, even though you can't hear, but you're sure, then you're 100% about it. Your wudu will break. He explained to him, he said, "Oh, astaghfirullah, for the past 20 years I've been acting upon this hadith, which I picked up a translation in the library and read it. And 20 years, I'm sure I passed, but I always try to hear. Sometimes that's my best. Do you hear anything? No. Can you smell anything? No. Allah." You understand the point? This is basically the example of a person who picks up a hadith and tries to act upon it himself. He's not qualified, we are not qualified to pick up hadiths ourselves and act upon them.